Okay, we're going to be doing a neurological test for the lower body for space-occupying lesions of the lumbar spine. And the slump test is a very good test for finding out for adverse neural tension or for a space-occupying lesion of the lumbar spine. It's one of my go-to tests that I use in clinic for neurological problems. So the person is showing sharp shooting pain, numbness, tingling in the leg, in the foot, in the ankle. I usually recommend the slump test. Straight leg raise works as well, but the slump test does a pretty good job of finding out if there's a problem neurologically in the lower body. So what we're going to have Megan do is put her hands behind her back, just like that. Great. I want you to slump. That's it. Very easy. Very good at that. That's great. So slump down. We're just going to have her flex her head down. I'm going to apply pressure in this region and on her head at the same time. Okay? Mm-hmm. Now, what I want you to do is I want you to... You can do this actively. You can have her do it actively, or you can do it yourself, but for most people, having the person actively do it is quite simple. So I want you to extend your leg. Great. Perfectly. Any shooting pain down the leg at all?
No.
Great. I want to bring your head, bring your toe towards your head. Good. Now, if there was positive signs with that, I'd have her now look up the ceiling. That should diminish them. And when she puts her head back down again, that should reproduce the pain. And just let your leg drop. Good. Okay, we're going to do the straight leg raise, which is somewhat similar to the slump test. It's for a space-occupying lesion of the lumbar spine, a disc, something encroaching in the foramen space. It's very similar to slump test, though it's done in a supine position. So how we want to do this, we're going to bring leg up. I want to adduct ADD, immediately rotate, bring it up, and if she gets back pain, sharp shooting pain down the leg, from that, I drop it down and I dorsiflex. If that reproduced it, it's highly probable there's something going on in the lumbar spine. The other thing I can do is I can have her flex her neck and I can dorsiflex at the same time. And you can see the similarities between the slump test and the straight leg raise. Great, thank you. So if there's a space occupying lesion, it reproduces the pain in through the leg. Here, I drop it down a little bit, dorsiflex, reproduces it. Again, it's highly probable there's something going on neurologically in the lumbar spine. Okay, so there's something called the well leg raise, which you're testing the opposite leg first. You're testing the leg opposite to where the person is having the pain. So if Megan was having pain down this leg, I would do the straight leg raise on the opposite side. It's called the well leg raise. And if it reproduced pain down this side, it usually indicates that the lesion is a little larger than normal. It's a fairly large lesion that's causing the nerve root. So it's exactly the same as the straight leg raise, but done on the opposite side. So bring the leg up, immediately rotate, and yes, abduct, immediately rotate, bring it up. And if she had pain down this leg, that means it's highly probable that it's a space-occupying lesion and may be fairly large. Okay, the modified way of doing the straight leg raise is from a sideline position. Again, remember, what we're trying to do is, if there's a space-occupying lesion in the lumbar spine, such as a disc, it's putting pressure on a nerve, we're stretching the sciatic nerve, and when you tug on a nerve that's inflamed and irritated, it usually responds negatively, which will help confirm. That's why we use special tests to help to confirm, to find out if there's tissue that's being affected. So we have to stress it or pull on it or do some shearing forces to identify the tissue problem. So the modified version of a straight leg raise is from a sideline position. I bring the leg up, I adduct, immediately rotate, bring it up. If there's pain, I drop it down a little bit, recreation of pain down the leg, and do dorsiflexion. If that increases pain again, it would be positive for a space-occupying lesion of a lumbar spine. Okay, we're going to do Valsalva, which increases intrathecal pressure. And the simple way of doing it is ask your client to take their thumb, put their lips against their thumb, and blow like they're blowing up a balloon. Increases pressure in through here, which will apply increased pressure on the disc, and the disc, if there is a disc that's prolapsed a bit, it'll put more pressure on the nerve, which will recreate more symptoms down the leg. So take your right thumb, give it a blow. Good, great. So it increases pressure in through here, which increases the pressure on the disc and the nerve and pain. This is a Farfan test. It's a gentle test to test in the facet joints, the lumbar spine, the joint capsules, the supraspinous ligament, intraspinous ligament. So you place your hand over T12, just find T12 here, and your other hand on the ASIS, and it's a rotational movement. So I'm applying pressure, a little bit of pressure down as I'm doing this, and you can rotate and move your hand down along the spinous processes to test the joint capsule, the sets, supraspinous and intraspinous ligaments of the lumbar spine. So it's a not very specific test. If you found something positive with this, then you would try to narrow down with other tests to find out what tissue that is causing the problem. Yeah, we're going to show the Pheasant's test, which it's testing for instability of the lumbar spine. You can use joint play. Joint play is pretty good for testing for the instability of the lumbar spine. This is a quick, simple test to find out if there's discomfort in S1, L5, L4, or pain goes down the legs as you do bring the heels to the buttocks. So just putting your hand over the L4, L5, doing compression, the heels to the buttocks. If there's pain produced in through here, it could be some instability of the lumbar vertebra and or pain down the legs when you apply pressure up like this. This could be related to a lower cross weakness of some of the lower cross muscles. Okay, we're going to test the facet joints, lumbar spine. The quadrant test challenges the facets, and it does diminish the frontal space to some degree of the lumbar spine. So what I want her to do, there's a couple different ways of doing it. What I'd like you to do is I would like you to rotate your shoulders this way. Okay? I want to put your hand back here, and I want you to reach back and touch the back of your leg. Okay, so that's a rotation and extension at the same time. Come up. And the other way I can do it is I can have you cross your hands in front of you. I can have her extend back, rotate, and I can apply pressure like this. That's another way of doing it. So extend back, and I rotate you the other way, rotate this way, and apply pressure in a direction downward that puts pressure on the facet joints and the intervertebral space, challenging the facet joints, or this facet joint irritation or discomfort. It would certainly show with this test.